Hi my friends, it's me Kayla. How's it going and welcome back to another one of my videos. Today I'm going to be sharing with you guys how to register for classes at FIT. I'm gonna give you guys the rundown, tips, and step-by-steps on how I go about registering for classes. And I hope this is very helpful because there is not a lot of resources, especially here online, on how to register for classes. Keep in mind that I do make a lot of content based around FIT and academics in general. So subscribe if you're interested in that content, but let's get started with the video. Before we begin, of course, this is my experience. I'm just a student at the school. I don't work for the school. I'm not part of academic advisement. So if you have any serious questions that you really don't know, go ahead, check online at FIT. They have a lot of different resources. I'll link it down below for you guys as well. So registering for classes probably begins a lot earlier than you think. Be prepared to look at your email and check your email often. Once you get an email about registering for the next semester's courses, that's kind of your check-in to yourself to say, all right, this process is starting. Let's start looking for classes for the next semester. Academic advisement will notify you and keep you on track, so don't worry about having to do everything yourself. There's a lot of resources that people don't take advantage of that you definitely can, so that way you're not kind of being left behind and you don't really know what's happening. So after those emails have been sent, you're going to see that they're going to advise you to meet with an academic advisor. And I'm going to do the same exact thing as a student. It's extremely important and valuable to meet with an academic advisor. It's really easy to schedule a meeting with one. All you have to do is go on to MyFIT, and there's going to be an option to schedule an appointment with your academic advisor and really start the process of registering for classes, hear what they have to say and their recommendations as well. When you're set to meet with an academic advisor, you're going to get an email, probably personally from the person you're meeting, and they're going to tell you kind of what you need to do before your appointment. And one of those things is going to be to run your DARS. Your DARS allows you to keep track of everything that you've completed up until the point you run it, and stuff that you still need to complete, like courses and all these other types of credits that you're going to have throughout the next couple of semesters. To run your DARS, it's also very simple. They give steps on how to do it in the email that you will be getting. So just keep in mind that running your DARS is something you should get comfortable with. Also, you should learn how to read your DARS. That way, you yourself can prepare and not always have to rely on an academic advisor. When you finally meet with your academic advisor, take note of their recommendations. They're going to go through your DARS with you, ask your questions. From my personal experience, they're extremely kind, really nice and easy people to work with and talk to. So go ahead, ask your questions. They will answer for you. But take note of what they're saying. Take a screenshot, write them down of the recommended courses that they're telling you to take. This is going to be your guideline. This can be what you follow to take courses for, and it should be. That way, it's a lot easier for you to just look up the courses that you need to take, and then you could just kind of find the times you want to pick yourself. So everything I've told you up till now, I recommend that you do right when you get that email from academic advisement about registration. That way, you're not going to be stuck not having an appointment because they're gonna be all filled, like the days and the week of registration. And that way, you're just gonna be prepared ahead of time. So when do you actually register for classes after you know what you need to register for? That comes down to your registration date and time. And this varies person by person. It has a lot to do whether you're a first or second year student. So that happens in the registration tab under MyFIT, and it's gonna allow you to actually check your registration date and time. Take note of your time and your date so that way you're prepared before that day and you're ready sitting at your computer to register like 5 minutes before that time. So now you know what classes you need to register for, you have a resource, you've met with academic advisement, and you know your registration date and time. Now what you need to do is make mock schedules. Have at least 2 schedules down already with your numbers and your courses that you know you want to take. That way, you're not scrambling and searching when you have to register. You're gonna be left with not a lot of choices, and you might be really upset with the choices that you do have because it's not with a certain professor, it's not at a certain time that's gonna fit your schedule. So go ahead, make at least 2 schedules. You could look at the courses that are open, the dates that they are, the times that they are. I highly recommend going going on Rate My Professor, do some research about them, and also ask around if you know people who maybe have taken a class with a certain professor. So it's the night before you register for classes. I highly recommend that you check up on the classes you want to take. Take note, like I said, of the class number and the course number. That way you know what to type in when you have to register, because the classes that you had on your schedule 3 days ago might be full already because upperclassmen have already been able to register for them before you have. So when you go to register for classes, you're gonna have a web page that looks a lot like this. I'm gonna insert a picture for you guys so you could see it better, but basically you wanna keep track of the CRN number. This is a number that is the course that you're gonna take. It represents the course that you want to take, the time you're going to take it, the professor. That is the number code that you're going to be taking. So it's really important to have those numbers in a document so you can copy and paste them down when you add classes to the worksheet on MyFIT. Which leads me to the day of registration. Be ready, sitting at your computer, and make sure that you have your numbers ready to type in. Sometimes you just are stuck being on a wait list. And being on a wait list to me is extremely frustrating because you're not sure if you have that class or not. So you may be stuck having to take a summer class, paying extra for online classes. So it's really important to decide if you wanna see if you get off the wait list and into the class, because sometimes that can take a lot longer than you expect. If you come down to a situation where the class that you have to take that semester for your major related courses, if that's all full and you're put on a wait list and you're like the fifth person on the wait list and there's no other classes available, go ahead and look at your next semester requirements. You could take one of the next semester requirements if there's no prerequisites. So just make sure you're paying attention to classes you can take and what you need before you take them. I've definitely heard a lot about how people get frustrated, especially during this part of registration, how FIT doesn't make it a super easy process. And I'm not gonna lie, I don't think it's an easy process at all, but it's just the planning that you have to do beforehand. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful for those really looking to register for classes and how to do it. I'll leave all the links down below to anything you may need about registering at FIT. Once again, I am no way working with the school. I'm just a student that goes there looking to be a helping hand. Go ahead and feel free to DM me on Instagram at Kayla.Tobias. I'm always down to answer your messages and questions you may have about the school in general, or maybe even registering. So I really appreciate you guys. Have a lovely day. Remember, good vibes equals good souls, and I'll see you all in another one of my videos. Bye bye.